Finding this will make you a millionaire. Hey everyone, it's Lexa again, and welcome back to Talltanic. You often hear fantastic tales of people who struck it rich by finding something of extreme value tucked away in a spot that you never imagined finding anything more than dust, dead cockroaches, and mothballs. But there's a strong chance that you might have something similar tucked away in your place. Let's see what you should be looking out for that could make you a millionaire. Before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Chances are high. It's been estimated that John Dunlop printed 200 copies of the original Declaration of Independence. Of those 200, only 26 are left. There is a chance that you could be as fortunate as a financial analyst who bought an old painting at a flea market for $4. Tucked away inside this cheap painting was one of the original copies of the Declaration of Independence, which fetched $2.42 million at auction in 1991. David Redden, the auctioneer at the time, said it was far and away the highest price for historical Americana ever. So finding one of these will make you an instant millionaire. Finders keepers. People lose cell phones all the time, and if you're lucky enough, someone will return your phone to you. However, if you lost the iPhone 3GS Supreme Rose by Stuart Hughes worth $2.9 million, the chances of it being returned are slim to none. Besides all the regular features that iPhones have, this phone sports a rare 7.5-carat single-cut diamond, a platinum bezel, 18-carat rose gold, a sprinkling of diamonds, and 4 2.5-carat pink baguette diamonds. If you found one of these, you too would be worth a fortune. Precious pearl. The price of an average pearl ranges between $300 to $1,500, and finding one would be good luck, but it's not going to make you a millionaire. Remember, when it comes to pearls, it's all about the size. Pick up a gigantic pearl, and you could be onto something. This happened to a fisherman in Puerto Princesa City, Philippines. He randomly entered his local tourism office in 2016 carrying the world's largest pearl. It weighed roughly 75 pounds and was said to be worth as much as $100 million. He had kept the pearl under his bed for 10 years, believing it was a good luck charm. Little did he know just how right he was. Time to plan your next diving trip. Gone fishing. While you're searching for pearls, keep your eyes open for the most expensive and rare fish in the world. The Asian arowana is said to be worth $400,000 for one, so you would need to find at least a couple of them to make millions. These rare beauties are found in several continents, and they are implanted with a microchip before they even mature. To give you an idea of their value, Singapore, as you might know, has an extremely low crime rate. But in just 1 week, 4 arowana were stolen. One thief stole from an elderly lady and literally ran away with the fish in a bucket. In Malaysia, 5 of them were stolen from a woman's home, and an aquarium owner lost his life when a thief came to steal his fish. During the Aquarama International Fish Competition in Singapore, 10 rare albino arowana had police escorts and armed guards just to get to their place of safety. Moon dust. In 1969, history was made when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin became the first people to step foot on the moon. While they were up there, they collected various samples and popped them in a bag. Fast forward a few decades, and the bag was accidentally auctioned off for $995 and bought by Nancy Carlson. They did their best to get the bag back, but their attempts were futile. She sold the bag at a Sotheby's auction in 2017 for $1.8 million. Suffice to say, if you find a random bag of moon dust, who knows? It could be the bag of dust from the very first moon landing. Artfully hidden. Art can be hidden in the most unexpected places, so never give up on your search to find a piece that could potentially be worth millions. A story to give you hope is that of Terry Horton. She came across a canvas in a thrift store that was filled with squiggly lines. She bought it to cheer up her friend, still cheekily admitting that she wasn't going to pay $8 for the painting, and only paid $5 because she quote-unquote didn't love her friend that much. Her plan was for them to throw darts at the piece. Long story short, the painting turned out to be an original Jackson Pollock and was said to be worth $50 million. Her initial reaction was, "Who the F is Jackson Pollock?" and it inspired a documentary about the famous piece. Tall tales. Garage sales and yard sales are always great to spend a few minutes rummaging through, but next time, invest a little more time in the art on sale because you could have had the same luck that Andy Fields had. This businessman from Tiverton, England was at a garage sale in Las Vegas, and he spent $5 on some sketches. The seller told him that the drawings used to belong to his aunt, who used to be Andy Warhol's babysitter. Sounds like a tall tale, doesn't it? Turns out, it was the truth. Warhol's signature was on the back of one of the sketches, which were valued at over $2 million. It almost, and I do mean almost, makes you want to keep your kids' doodles just in case. Instant millionaire. If you head over to Arkansas's Crater of Diamonds State Park, there is a strong possibility that you could leave there a lot wealthier than when you arrived. If you've never heard of this place before, here's the deal. There is a 37-acre plowed field which is home to many rocks, minerals, and gemstones, and anything you find there is yours to keep. To date, 33,100 diamonds have been found. A 71-year-old woman from Colorado has been lucky enough to find an ice-white diamond weighing nearly 3 carats. She has chosen to remain anonymous and said that within 10 minutes of searching, she had uncovered the jewel. At first, she thought she had just picked up a piece of glass and asked her son to pop it in his pocket just in case. Turns out it was the largest diamond that has been found in 2018. It's said that 1 in every 5 diamonds has been found near the surface. Lost and found. Billy the Kid was an old West American outlaw, and he was wanted for the murder of 8 men. His own life was taken from him at the age of 21. Now, take a close look at what he looks like. Have you seen any old photographs in your home that look like this guy? Go look, because one guy was said to have purchased an old photograph from an antique store for a paltry $2, and it ended up being a shot of him. And its worth is said to be upwards of $5 million. It shows him playing croquet and is only the 2nd legitimate photograph of Billy the Kid. Pocket change. It seems that artwork is certainly the item to look out for if you're looking at finding something that will make you an instant millionaire. Not only are garage and yard sales the place to hunt, but now you can add the upgrading of office space that is something that sometimes works too. A tool and die company in Indiana were selling off some old items of furniture and paintings which were purchased by an employee for $30. He took the painting and covered up an annoying hole in his home. Years later, he was playing a game called Masterpiece, where each player had to outbid the other on famous works of art, and to his surprise, there was a copy of his painting. Turns out the piece was an original by Martin Johnson Heed and fetched $1.2 million at auction and has received the name Magnolias on gold velvet cloth. A picture is worth 1,000 words. Or in this case, $2 million. eBay is full of treasures and you can lose yourself for hours browsing through the items that people are selling. If you've got the time and the knowledge, you might just be as fortunate as Justin Whiting. He was browsing through the site in 2017 when he spotted a photograph that bore a strong resemblance to Jesse James. James was an American outlaw, a bank and train robber, and leader of a gang back in the late 1880s. The photograph was purchased for $10 and is estimated to be worth $2 million. Quite exciting. Let's be honest, the chances of finding a Fabergé egg worth $1 million is slim to none, but it has been known to happen. A Fabergé egg is a jeweled egg made by Peter Carl Fabergé and his company between 1885 and 1917. Only 50 eggs were made, and most of them were for Russian Tsars Alexander III and Nicholas II. They were given as Easter presents to their wives and mothers, as you do when you are the richest men in the world, and they were called Imperial Fabergé eggs. Of the 50 that were made, only 43 remain. One was bought for $14,000 at a flea market, which turned out to be the real deal, and was actually worth in the region of $20 million. There's a good chance you could find one of the 7 unaccounted for eggs. Head under the blanket. When you think of blankets, you don't think of them as having much value, but that's about to change. Navajo rugs and blankets were made by the Navajo people of the United States. It's believed the Navajo people learned their skills from the Pueblo Indians around 1000 AD. The story of Lauren Kreitzler will make you go scratch around your cupboard. He saw a blanket on the Antiques Roadshow, which sold for $500,000. He realized he had something very similar in his home, which went on to fetch $1.5 million at auction. His one was from the 1800s and had been used by his grandmother to catch newborn kittens as they were born. Home run. Baseball cards have the tendency to bring in a few bucks for people, and sometimes a few million. One man inherited cards valued at $1 million from his great-great-grandmother. She used to run a boarding house in Boston, and the Boston Red Sox stayed with her for over a year between 1871 and 1872. The real money spinner was a letter written to his great-great-grandmother thanking her for her fabulous cooking, and it includes notes by future Hall of Fame members Albert Spalding and Harry and George Wright. Handle with care. A good route around your cupboards might produce something similar to the images we're showing you, and who knows, you might be as fortunate as a New York family who picked one up at a garage sale for $3. It was a dish from the Jin Dynasty, and theirs sold for $2.2 million. Life is a beautiful ride. As a general rule of thumb, cars lose value every single day. Unless, of course, it's a timeless piece that does the exact opposite. The chances of finding a rare car that you're not aware of in your family might not be very high, but let me assure you, it does happen. In Western France, a barn was discovered that had 60 classic cars inside. The cars had a value of $18 million. Before we get to number one, let us ask you guys something. What are the chances that your home or your family is harboring something extremely valuable? Share your stories with us in the comments below. Number one, time to play. If you had $5 million, you could purchase one yourself, but finding one would be so much cooler. We're talking about an original, Madame Alexandre Eloise doll, of which only five exist in the world. The doll is named after the person who handmade her, Madame Alexandre, and she's kitted out to the max. She has Christian Dior clothes, Oscar de la Renta fur, and Catherine Bowman accessories, as well as Swarovski crystals and 9-carat diamonds. You can buy a replica on Amazon for $180. Oh.